everyone. If I could please have your attention, we'd like to go ahead and begin. Well, welcome to this morning's Profiles Breakfast, the second in our series this year. And this morning's topic is the 2016 Republican National Convention. And at this time, I would like to introduce our County Commissioner, Casey Kozlowski, also a member of the leadership class of 2016 this year, to introduce our speaker for today. Thanks, Casey.
Good morning. How are we doing this morning? Good. Well, it certainly is a pleasure to be here today, and it's great to see so many folks joining us here this morning to learn about a major event that's taking place in the region next year. The Republican National Convention is scheduled to take place July 18th through the 21st of next year, and its impact on downtown Cleveland and really Northeast Ohio as a whole is going to be very exciting. The last time a political nominating convention was hosted in Cleveland was in 1936, actually, when 17,000 people packed the Cleveland Public Hall for the Republican National Convention. Fast forward 79 years, and today, once again, our region has an opportunity to shine and showcase our many offerings. The City of Cleveland put together a very impressive package and made a great pitch and was successful in securing the 2016 convention over Cincinnati, Columbus, Denver, Kansas City, Las Vegas, and Phoenix. With Ohio being a bellwether state and a must-win for either political party, both eyes and ears are sure to be on Cleveland and all of Ohio next year. With an expected 50,000 people in attendance and with 15,000 media credentials issued in the region, there certainly is going to be a lot of people in the area exploring all that our area has to offer. That is why here in Ashtabula County, with the help of many in the room here today, actually, we've formed a committee that has focused our efforts on capitalizing on the convention and making this something that benefits Ashtabula County as well. Of course, we all know the many offerings that we have here in the region, including our parks, our beaches, Lake Erie, Pymatuni Lake, our wineries, our covered bridges, our great restaurants, our airport, our business and industry in the area. They all play a role in both the national and international stage. And what most people also don't realize is actually in our area, we're home to the Joshua Giddings Law Office, which was actually one of the founders of the Republican Party and actually wrote a plank in the first national Republican Party platform. Here in Ashtabula County, it's been our goal to highlight those many offerings and get information out in front of the attendees so that people can spend time to explore our area before, during, and even after the convention. And it's also important that we share the story that Ashtabula County has to tell. With the fact that there's going to be expected 15,000 media in the region, it's our hope that we can attract some of those folks to write about the many positives and potential for growth that we have here in Ashtabula County. When I mention our county's offerings, I mention the many companies that have a role on the national and international stage. We want to share these stories and explain to folks that products can and are made in America, and many of which are made right here in Ashtabula County. Our work here as a planning committee to try to capitalize on the RNC in Ashtabula County has a great amount of focus on many facets, and that includes event planning, transportation, capitalizing on the media component, providing an historical perspective, and also engaging our youth and young adults in the political process. So it's with a great pleasure that we actually reached out to Mike and asked if he would come to Ashtabula County today to offer some insight into what the RNC means for the region. So with that being said, I'm going to introduce Mike Mulhall, who's with Destination Cleveland, and he's got a program prepared for us this morning. So let's give him a warm round of applause and welcome him to Ashtabula County. Thank you.
Morning, everyone. Is this working okay? All right, great. So privileged to be here today. It really is. And looking forward to sharing some insights on how Northeast Ohio is preparing to host some of the big numbers that Casey mentioned, and hopefully answer some questions and just have you leave here today excited about the convention, coming to Northeast Ohio, understanding ways that we hope to connect you to the convention, and in general, just being more informed. So that's really the goal of the presentation today. I'm gonna I've prepared some slides for you that we'll go through, and then hopefully if I don't talk too much, we'll have plenty of time for Q&A as well. So I'm looking forward to that at the end. And just understanding, there's a couple of things. As my boss likes to say, the cake is not fully baked yet. So there are some things we don't know all the answers to. But we'll do our best to share everything that we know with the team today. So hopefully this guy works. So as Casey mentioned, I am with Destination Cleveland, and I always like to take a moment to make sure everyone understands who we are as an organization, because I know when I get out and talk to people, they're like, okay, I know there's the Greater Cleveland Partnership and Downtown Cleveland Alliance and Global Cleveland and all these other organizations, and so which one are you? So we're Destination Cleveland. We used to be Positively Cleveland, and we're really about bringing visitors to the region. So each of those organizations that I mentioned are community partners of ours, but we really focus on visitation. So getting people from outside the region to come and enjoy everything that Northeast Ohio has to offer. And we like to call it other people's money, like bring other people's money into the region. So that's what we focus on. We are funded almost entirely through the Cuyahoga County bed tax. So 90% of our funding, even a little more, you know how when you go and visit somewhere and you stay in a hotel and you have a sales tax and then you have those additional taxes that annoy you? Well, a piece of that funds us. So the idea is that as we fill hotel rooms, which is really our job, we take in more money and we simply reinvest that money in marketing and selling Northeast Ohio. So we are a nonprofit. We don't answer to, we answer to a board of directors, but we don't answer to shareholders or an owner. Everything we take in gets reinvested in marketing the community. A couple of departments within our organization that I should mention to you. First and probably most important is convention sales and service. So as you know, a couple years ago, we opened a brand new convention center in downtown Cleveland. How many of you have been there? Pretty good number. If you haven't, I'd strongly encourage you to get there and see it. We, you know, for all intents and purposes, Northeast Ohio was out of the convention business in a meaningful way for about 30 years. We had an antiquated convention center and just didn't allow us to compete at a high level with some of our peer set cities. That has changed. And it's probably been the, you know, of all the development that's happened, it's probably been the number one thing that has spurred additional development, and certainly in our world has been very, very meaningful. So we have a whole team that basically is out every day selling Cleveland to associations and companies and things like that that do conventions to bring that business to Northeast Ohio. We also do a lot of marketing. So we have marketing that supports the convention sales end of the business, but also leisure marketing. So we're out there, talking to people in Chicago and Detroit and Pittsburgh and Columbus and Cincinnati and saying, hey, come visit Northeast Ohio. Here are all the amazing assets that we have. I get asked a lot about our marketing. There people are like, I never see anything that you guys are doing. You know, I see all these Pure Michigan campaigns and things like that. Well, the reality of it is we're not marketing to you because you're already here. So that's why you don't see our stuff. If you go into some of the markets I mentioned earlier, you will see that we're out there in a pretty aggressive way selling Northeast Ohio. I oversee our partnership department, so we have 700 community partners that we work with. It's a lot of exactly who you'd expect it to be. So it's the hospitality community, hotels, restaurants, major attractions, Browns, Cavs, Indians, people like that. And basically, we're really trying to work with them to advance our mission. We have 50 full-time employees, and while they're passionate Clevelanders to a fault almost, there's still only 50 of them. But when we partner with 700 organizations with, in some cases, thousands of employees, we feel like we can, we have such a more exponential opportunity to spread our message. So that's how we look at partnerships. And then the last one I'll mention is destination development. So one of the really critical pieces that our research has shown us to a visitor deciding to come to a destination is how that destination looks, acts, and feels when you're there. So do you feel safe? Do you feel like the residents and the locals are friendly? Is it easy to navigate? All those kinds of things. So we've actually formed a department that focuses and advocates on behalf of all those kinds of things. So trying to really make sure that we look, act, and feel really good to a visitor. And if you think about places that you've visited that, you know, you'd recognize to be tourist destinations, they usually have, you feel safe when you're there. Their frontline staff and cab drivers and people like that are typically friendly and understand the importance of tourism. So that's what that department focuses on. So why does it matter? And this all ties back to RNC, so I'll get there. But just some stats to throw at you. Nearly $3 billion in visitor-related infrastructure happened tied to tourism from 2009 to 2014. So that's things like a massive upgrade to the Cleveland Museum of Art, one of our truly greatest assets. It's the convention center. It's a lot of the hotel development. It's the casinos. It's just a lot of the things that you've heard and seen. It's what's happening in the flats right now, which is absolutely breathtaking. So much good stuff happening, and it's all tied to our industry, which really helps us do our job better. We had 16.9 million visitors to Cuyahoga County in 2014. That's up 4.5% over the prior year, and the national average is 3.4%. So the news is good. You know, we're growing, and we're growing faster than both the national and state averages. So Northeast Ohio is pretty hot right now. $7.4 billion in economic impact the last time we measured, which was 2013. So almost 65,000 jobs tied to the tourism industry. And most people don't realize that. You know, we're the fourth leading employer as an industry in Cuyahoga County. It's tourism-related jobs. And nearly $1 billion in taxes through tourism. So think about that. That's $1 billion less dollars that our company, people who own businesses or own homes in Cuyahoga County have to cough up. So the point is it's meaningful economic. It's a meaningful economic driver. Our biggest challenge at Destination Cleveland is changing perceptions. All of you, if you're from Northeast Ohio, you know when you travel and you tell somebody where you're from, they usually have some sort of smart aleck comment about Cleveland, right? And that's a negative. A, it's not funny because our river hasn't burned for like 45 years, but they still want to bring that stuff up, right? But B, it's a perception that makes it challenging for our teams when they're out selling conventions and things along those lines. Is just, people who haven't been here and experienced it really don't know oftentimes what we really have. And so we're working really hard to change those perceptions. It's the number one thing that we need to do in order to get over that hump to then sit down and have meaningful conversations about bringing your event to us. So the good news is perceptions are changing. I have, no lie, a list, and I can send it to you guys, of probably 50 media outlets that have included Cleveland on some sort of positive list over the past 12 months. And I don't know about you guys, but I remember when we used to be on a lot of lists, but they weren't the kind that you wanted to be on. That is really changing, and we really are hot. And this stuff matters. This helps change perceptions all over the country. So I just listed a handful here, but notice they're meaning. They're really well-respected media outlets. So Travel and Leisure listed us as one of the best places to visit in 2015. We were the only city in the United States on that list, and we were with places like Florence, Italy, and the Netherlands. New York Times, 52 places to go in 2015. We were on there with, picture France, Australia, and then Cleveland, Ohio. The LA Times, 15 destinations for travelers to set their sights on, Barbados, Paris, and Cleveland. Men's Journal just named us one of the 50 best places to live. Thrill List, Cleveland is one of the 11 best drinking cities in America. Congratulations. Yeah. Time.com, this one just came out recently. Number 7 on America's best food cities. Our food scene is red hot, and thanks to Michael Simon and some of our other chefs. And that's something that we really hear over and over again is, man, you got to tell me about your food scene. So all that stuff is, it all helps. So in 284 days from today, as Casey mentioned, next July 18th, we'll be welcoming 50-plus thousand visitors to our region. And that is pretty much what our staff looks like every morning now. So some facts and figures around RNC, and some of this Casey already hit on. RNC summer meeting, so this already happened. This was this past August, and this happened around the debate, if you guys remember that we hosted the debate. So, but during that time, for a week, we had about 400 delegates in downtown Cleveland, staying at the Renaissance, seeing our city, but they were having meetings up for the Republican National Committee. It was a great, like, dry run and first step at getting them excited about our community. And I'm proud to say that Ashtabula County was represented. Is Jackie here from the CVB? Hey. So we invited a bunch of regional CVBs to those meetings so that they could interact with the delegates and start to plant the seeds about, hey, while you're here, come visit, you know, the Pro Football Hall of Fame or Ashtabula's wineries or Cedar Point or things like that. So we really had a couple of days of really starting to get them excited about all the amazing assets that we have in Northeast Ohio. So I wanted to make sure everyone knew that that opportunity existed. It's the first time any city has ever done that. And we're doing a lot of those kinds of innovative things to help ensure that we maximize this opportunity. Dates of the convention are listed. We need 16,000 hotel rooms. This is a hot topic everyone wants to know about. We're almost there in terms of contracted hotels. We'll get there. As far as the footprint goes, which everyone likes to know, I will tell you they come as far east, and that's what matters to you guys, I would think, as Quail Hollow. So that's part of the room block. They go south to Fairlawn Copley. They go west to Elyria and probably even Sandusky. So to get that many rooms, you need that. We'll have by next summer 5,000 rooms downtown. There'll be 1,200 special events that happen during the week of the convention. 1,200 special events. So think about the opportunities that presents to DJs and AV companies and caterers and things like that. Highlights of the convention: we'll throw a welcome reception for the delegates and the media on Friday, Sunday night, and then the big other two nights at the convention are the Wednesday night when their vice presidential candidate will accept the nomination, and Thursday night is the culmination with their nominee for president giving the acceptance speech. So those are the big highlights. And it's at so everyone's clear, the actual convention, it will be held at Quicken Loans Arena, probably a month after the Cavs win the world championship, we hope. So what is the Republican National Convention? It's a catalyst for visitation to the region. As Casey mentioned, so it's the second largest media event in the world. Anyone want to take a shot at what's the biggest media event in the world? Heard Super Bowl? Olympics. So it is the Olympics. Super Bowl is usually the number one answer when I ask that question. The biggest Super Bowl ever, which was the one held in New York, credentialed 6,000 media. We're credentialing 15,000. So just to give you an idea of the scale. So biggest media event. The Summer Olympics is the only thing bigger than the RNC and the DNC from a media standpoint. It's a statement to meeting planners, and this is some of the stuff that really I hope you take away today. Our leads for RFPs for conventions were up just last year. We learned we were getting the convention July 8th last year. Our leads for the balance of the year were up 22%. So those are other conventions going, man, I better take a look at Cleveland. I didn't realize they have a new convention center. I didn't realize they had the hotel product because 5 years ago we didn't. Now we do, and it made people sit up and notice. What it's not, part of our job as the host committee is to make sure that we also manage expectations, and while we can't predict everything, one thing I can predict with pretty good certainty is that not everyone in this room is going to be, or me, is going to be able to retire on July 24th of next year. So we want to make sure that you guys understand that while there is a significant economic impact, you know, not everyone is going to be able to ride off into the sunset with bags of money. couple of other things that I think it's really important to point out. You'll hear about two organizations as the convention gets closer. So there's the host committee, which our organization is you know, very involved with. And actually our president, David Gilbert, is also the CEO of the host committee. The host committee's job is to raise the money needed to put on the convention and to make sure that Northeast Ohio benefits from it. So I want to be very clear about that. That is their role. They're completely apolitical. They're a 501c3 setup. They legally can't do anything from a political standpoint. And I want to say to everyone in this room, whether you're the most staunch Democrat on the planet or vice versa, if you're from Northeast Ohio, you should be glad this event is coming here. So, I talked to some people who are like, I don't want anything to do with it. I'm a Democrat. That's not the attitude that we're looking for people to have. I think Mayor Jackson, who is a Democrat, said it best. You know, it's not about red and it's not about blue. It's about green. And that's really how we look at it. So that's that on the host committee. So then the other organization that you'll hear about is the Committee on Arrangements, and that's the group from the Republican National Committee that actually puts on the convention. So they're really responsible for everything that's happening in the walls of the queue. And so we work really closely with them, but understand that their goal is to put on a great convention, to really have a huge media event for the Republican Party, a positive PR event, and to get their candidate elected president of the United States. Our goal is different. Our goal is to make sure that we have a great event and that we maximize the opportunity for Northeast Ohio. So we raise a whole lot of money that they turn around and spend. But really, we're learning every day, how to work with them, understanding that there's two very different objectives. We can work together. It is going very well. But it's important to understand that. And like I said, make sure that as you hear more about those two sides of each organization, I think it's important to understand that. So why is it a win? First of all, as Casey mentioned, 50,000 visitors. Conservatively, it will be $200 million in direct spending. So that's not even a ripple effect. That means, transportation and hotel rooms and restaurants and all of those special events we talked about. Tampa was $214 million 4 years ago in a far worse economy. We think we're going to do it better than they did. And it's 4 years later in a much better economy. So we're actually hoping that it'll be north of $200 million. But that money is coming. 15,000 credential media, as we mentioned. And then the other big thing is it's a project accelerator, and we'll talk a little bit about that. So the media exposure is quite frankly the biggest reason why this is a win for the community. We have all of these amazing assets. Remember I talked about needing to change perceptions? We will have the spotlight of the world on Northeast Ohio. And we've got, what better time in our history to have that? And we've got this incredible opportunity now to showcase Northeast Ohio to the world in a very positive light and change those perceptions. Just in 2014, after the announcement, there were more than 12,000 positive online print and broadcast news stories about Cleveland, resulting in over 20 billion impressions. That's in 2014, a year and a half before the event. So think about what it'll be in 2016. And those of you who are in media and understand what 20 billion impressions means, you fully understand. There's no way you could ever pay enough money to get 20 billion impressions. One quick story I like to share that really made this concept hit home for me was there is a woman named Enid Mickelson, and Enid is a former congresswoman. She's from Utah, and she was the chairwoman of the site selection committee. She fell in love with Cleveland as part of the process and was actually, along with Ryan Priebus, the one that told us that we were awarded the convention. Being from Salt Lake City, she experienced similar things. When she would travel, she would tell somebody where she was from, and they would be like, well, if you're from Utah, how are you having a glass of wine? You're not allowed to have a glass of wine. And they would say things like, how many wives does your husband have? and things like that. And it's that same concept. You know, it's that same idea of just perceptions not equaling reality. You know, our river doesn't burn anymore. You know, all those things that Johnny Carson used to make jokes about, that's not reality anymore. And so, you know, she saw when they hosted the 2002 Winter Olympics in Salt Lake City how those perceptions changed, because again, they had that spotlight from the media, and it, you know, here we are 13 years later, and they're still seeing positive economic impact that they tie back to 2002. You know, now they showcase Salt Lake as this cool, clean, you know, mountain city that you got to go visit. And so it's really changed things, and we hope this for the same in Northeast Ohio. Thing to point out, if you don't know, and you know, we certainly, again, working with your CVB, have been sharing this information. It's the heart of vacation season. Normally, this convention takes place at the end of August. This time, it's in July. And so we're trying to leverage that to say, come early, stay late. And we're, again, we're working with all the regional CVBs to showcase all of Northeast Ohio and try to get more and more people to do that. There's no precedent for that. This is the first time it's ever fallen that time of year. In the first quarter of 2016, we will actually launch a campaign that will start to market to all of the delegations about that. So really starting to encourage that to happen. That will be through Destination Cleveland, the Convention and Visitors Bureau. It'll be primarily digital. It's expensive to do TV and things like that, you know, nationwide. We don't have a massive budget, so we'll be doing our best through digital and through social to push that out. I talked about it being a project accelerator. So who's been downtown lately? Who's been to the airport lately? Not fun, is it? Yeah. So we call that progress. It's a bear getting around downtown right now. The reason it's a bear is because we're getting all the streets repaved. You know, our airport is as much of a hassle as it is right now. I don't think anyone would argue with you that our airport needed a facelift, and it's getting one. All this stuff needs to get done by next June. Public Square is probably as exciting a project as I've ever been around. $32 million reinvention of the, you know, the center of our city that's happening right now. These are legacies that have, they're things that have to get done, but will leave a legacy long beyond next July 23rd. And we're all gonna benefit from that. You know, Public Square, I would encourage you to Google it and check out all the things planned for Public Square. They're not just reinventing it, but they're programming it for years to come, and there's money behind it. So it's not just build it and then, you know, the Republicans leave and it's just sitting there, but there's it's really being reinvented. Again, the airport's getting a facelift. We'll all benefit from that for years. The road construction, we'll all benefit from all that stuff for years to come. So these are all, the new convention center hotel, I didn't even touch on that. Brand new 600-room Hilton. It's gonna be absolutely amazing. It's connected to the convention center. It will help us sell conventions. It will have spectacular views. It's gonna have an amazing lounge on the 32nd floor. Best views in the city. Out in all four directions, spectacular. So all this stuff, we have that hotel opening and two other, there's a Drury going in at the old Cleveland Board of Education building that is going to be amazing. It's a historic building. And same thing on East 9th and Euclid across from where you used to work. The Schofield is going in, in a historic building that they're redoing. So all kinds of stuff. And not to mention streetlights being fixed and sidewalks cracks being taken care of and things like that. So really focusing on getting the city ready. So how can you get involved? There's a number of ways. Number one, we need 8,000 volunteers to welcome these guests to our city. You can sign up. There's a website. Basically, 2016cle.com is a great place for all of you to engage with the convention. So you know, volunteers are not necessarily going to be escorting the candidate onto the stage on Thursday night. Sorry if that bursts anyone's bubble, but again, we're managing expectations. What you can picture is being an ambassador for your community, and whether it's, you know, being an airport greeter or working hotel lobbies and making sure people know where they're supposed to go and how to get there, and just really being a friendly, smiling face, welcoming our guests. There's a supplier guide. So we have one of our jobs, again, is to make sure that Northeast Ohio benefits. One of the ways we're doing that is by making it really easy for the Committee on Arrangements and delegations to spend their money with local companies. So we've created a supplier guide. If you're a business owner or work for a business that is, a caterer, or there's actually over 100 categories that the RNC told us they'll need. And you can sign up to do that. It takes about 10 minutes to fill out the form. We basically just confirm that you're a real business, an established business. You didn't just, form in your basement 2 weeks ago to get ready for RNC. And that you're from Northeast Ohio. As long as those two criteria are met, you can be part of the supplier guide. They're already using the supplier guide. They're already spending money in Northeast Ohio because of it. And we're encouraging every business to sign up for it. So that's one way, important way to get involved. And again, there's over 100 categories. And then the other thing I always get asked about, so I put it on the slide, is renting your house. I'm not sure we'll get out to Ashtabula County in terms of rentals. We are not in this business, but if you know people that want to rent their house, that's the website to do it. So the RNC struck a deal with Howard Hanna. So that's that. Again, I don't know a whole lot about it other than that's where you go to do it. Talked about volunteering and the supplier guide, and I'm happy to answer any questions afterwards. You can also sign up for a newsletter. There's no reason not to do that, right? It's free. The supplier guide is free also. But this will just keep you informed as things move along. Here's what's happening. Here are road closures. Here's how to prepare. Here's some wins. Here's some things that are happening. Here's when the airport's going to be done. All that kind of stuff will be shared on that newsletter. So I hope some of that information is helpful. Hopefully some of it's new information to you. A couple of things that I would share, and Casey hit on one of them. We haven't hosted a convention in 80 years. We should be extremely proud of the fact that we won this convention. One of the cities that you didn't mention was Dallas. And Dallas was actually the other finalist with Cleveland. I'll tell you a great story. Dallas, of course, said, we're Dallas. We couldn't possibly lose to Cleveland, Ohio in this competition, right? So they actually invited media in the room when they took the call to... when they knew they were getting the call about whether or not they chose Cleveland, or chose the site. And so they had media in there. So it was a very awkward 10 minutes when they took the call that said, nice try, we're coming to Cleveland. So we're very proud of that. We did not invite media into the room. Probably in hindsight, maybe we should have, right? But that was a really cool thing, and I will also share with you that the site selection committee voted unanimously to come to Cleveland. And I will tell you that I don't think at the beginning of the process they expected to come to Cleveland, but we really won them over with our effort and our attitude and our collaboration and our assets. So again, it's a once-in-a-generational opportunity. Embrace it, enjoy it, get involved with it. Our advice is, come downtown, check it out, be part of it. It's likely the only time it'll happen in our lifetime. So that's certainly one thing. And the other thing I want to make sure that I say publicly, and David, our CEO, talks about it all the time, is we really look at the RNC as the start line, not the finish line. We think it's a springboard for all kinds of new economic impact. And that's really how, so we know that $200 million's coming, and that's great, and we're going to be ready. But if we do it right, the real opportunity exists post-event. And that's how, that's really our approach, and I think it's the right approach. So with that, thank you. And I'm going to stick around and answer questions. I'd also share, those are all our social media ways to connect. I would encourage you to do that and engage with the social media that the host committee is putting out. There may be opportunity to promote Ashtabula County through some of our social channels. So again, just encourage you to get involved that way. With that, I'm happy to answer any questions that anybody has. Yes, Jackie.
Can you talk
Sure. Yeah, so I talked about needing 16,000 hotel rooms. The way that works is we secure a block on their behalf, but the Committee on Arrangements actually assigns delegations to each of those hotels next year. So we don't know who's staying where yet. And a lot of that has to do with things like, for example, let's say that the candidate is, that the nominee ends up being from Idaho. The Idaho delegation will not be at Quail Hollow. The Idaho delegation will be somewhere, you know, at the New Hilton or at the Marriott or somewhere right downtown. So there's a lot of factors that go in, you know, obviously the size of the delegation, things like that. So we really don't have any say-so in that. We basically just secured the room blocks, and then they determine who goes where. And it's the same thing with the event venues. The Committee on Arrangements will tell the they'll tell XYZ delegation, your event is at the Rock Hall on Tuesday night, or, you know, based on what they're trying to accomplish. Is that what you want? Yep. Now, they can ask. My understanding is a delegation, if a delegation fell in love with an area or a hotel as part of their visits, they can request that, but it's not a guarantee. The other thing I should mention on supplier guide is we don't control where any of the money gets spent. We just try to make it really easy for them. So just so that, I don't know if I made that clear, but. That is correct. Yep.
And how about like these little cards that we got when we were in Cleveland? Do you have any of these here that people can keep so that we're Facebooking, tweeting, Instagram, and YouTube, all those icons here at the bottom of the screen? Now, this is what you need to do to follow and promote the RNC through here in Ashtabula County.
Yep. So I did not bring any of those, but how about if I send you some and then you can help distribute them? Jackie's with the Ashtabula County Convention and Visitors Bureau, if you don't know. What other questions? Yes, sir.
All of this sounds wonderful for Ohio, but
I knew there was a but coming.
What could go wrong, and what contingency plans have you made?
Yep. So no, that's a super fair question. There's a lot that can go wrong, obviously, and really what we can do, and we are doing, is preparing for that. So preparing for every potential scenario. So we have a crisis communication group that's what they're working on. We're working with the Secret Service, who handles all of the security for the event. You know, what we can do is over-prepare for things like that and then pray we never have to implement any of those types of plans. You know, the one good thing is this isn't the first, while it's our first convention, it's not the first convention. And so the Secret Service knows what they're doing. You know, the party knows what they're doing. And, you know, we feel comfortable that we're going to be as prepared as we can possibly be. Yes, sir.
I know everybody in the room is excited that Cleveland stands to gain $200 million to benefit. I think this room would be very happy to try to help you get north of that number, to use your term.
That's awesome.
I think we'd also like to get north and east.
Yeah. Very good. Yes.
Can you talk about that a little bit and what the opportunities look like?
Yeah, again, I think that there's no precedent, as I mentioned, because it's never really fallen when the convention falls, which is heavy vacation season. The fact, like I said, that Jackie was out there already in front of the delegations last August, I think shows that, you know, we're committed to making that happen. We really can't predict whether or not it will. But we believe we have a lot to sell in Northeast Ohio. And we get paid through a Cuyahoga County bed tax. So we're not, but we're not looking at it that way. We're looking at this very regional. And we're saying, we know we need Cedar Point. We need the wineries. We need the Pro Football Hall of Fame to excite people about Northeast Ohio. Let's tell them the entire story and then let them make their decisions. So we're working really hard. I don't know how much of it will happen around the convention. We're hoping tons of it does. But maybe it's part of the process that gets people to do it a year from now, or 2 years from now, or 4 years. You know what I mean? So, again, the effort will be there behind it. It's tough to say how many people will take advantage of it. One thing we do know, when we get people here, they're blown away. People who haven't been here or haven't been here in 10 years, whether they're meeting planners or whether they're just visitors that stop in our visitor center, they're like, why does Cleveland get such a bad rap? There's so much to do here, and it's inexpensive, and you have all these amazing things. So we feel like this, again, this is why this is such a great long-term play.
Quick follow-up. You mentioned 1,200 events happening.
Yep.
And what's the date scope of that? Does that fall into that come early, stay late?
No, that's just like the week of the convention. And I'm glad you said that. So one thing that I would strongly encourage you to do, if you're a business owner that's already doing business or wants to do business with the hotels and things like that, you should be talking to them now, you know, because not every hotel, you know, a lot of hotels that they're staying in are limited service, right? So people are going to come back to the hotel and want to get a bite to eat and drinks, and they can't do it at, you know, pick a hotel that doesn't have that. Make sure if you're a restaurant or you're a venue or things like that, that you're connecting with those guys, because they're going to have some influence on some of this stuff. Because while there's 1,200 events, there's also, hey, let's go grab lunch or drinks or whatever. Golf, you know, all that stuff. You should be talking to all those kinds of individuals. Yes, sir.
Have you been in communication with United Airlines about them providing better service to Cleveland? I mean, it's nice that we're redoing Cleveland Hopkins.
Yep.
But obviously, you know, United Continental has its problems. And I really consider that a real risk, frankly, about how this all comes off.
Yep. So again, you know, that's one of those we can't control, but we can certainly advocate on that behalf. I can tell you that we do, you know, United Airlines is a partner. The airports are a partner, and we do communicate with them heavily. During the process of getting the site selection committee here and all that, we did have a really good experience working with the airport. They were very helpful. They understood the magnitude of these folks. But, you know, that's one of those that we can't control. But, of course, that just like everything else, we want to make sure that those kinds of things go smoothly. But I think it's a super fair point to bring up. You know, a lot of people ask about the airlift into Northeast Ohio, and are we going to be able to get all these people here? Well, obviously, these airlines are going to ramp up around the convention, so it won't be business as usual. They're going to make sure that they have more flights coming in and out of Cleveland and so forth. There's a really robust and complex transportation plan of not only getting people here, but then getting them around while they're here. And I know that was an issue in Tampa, so we really ultra-hyper-focused on it. And I think as part of the process of winning the bid was they were comfortable with our plan. Yes, Casey.
Do you have any ideas on how in Ashtabula County we can bring some folks from Cleveland out here before or after that event, or even during the event? Because I know many delegates will have their spouses with them probably.
Absolutely.
Are there any ideas that you have that maybe that we could jump on here in the county?
I think making sure that you're engaged with us social media-wise. I would be thinking about, all this media that's going to be in town is going to be looking for stories. And they may be national stories, but they're going to do it within the backdrop of Northeast Ohio. So what are your success stories? What are your real assets out here? You know, what are the things that would compel somebody to come out here? When you have that information, send that to us. And so when a media outlet comes to us and says, do you know anyone who does this or did this that we can talk to? You guys are at the top of mind. And we'll just continue working with you guys to help make those connections with the COA. I don't know if I mentioned this, but the Committee on Arrangements has, I think, 14 people here now living, working in the Halley Building downtown. They'll have 120 first quarter of next year. So we expect that communication to continue to ramp up. You know, I wouldn't, if I were you, or I wouldn't hesitate to send them information. Make sure that you're aware, hey, if you have a free weekend person at the COA, we'd love to invite you and show you around Ashtabula County, things like that. Yes, hi.
Actually, I attended the RNC convention in San Diego, and one of the things that we did have free time.
Yep.
So that's where probably Ashtabula County could really jump on that. Because you have free time, what we would have to do is try to bring ideas or events or whatever. We have Bridge Street. We have some areas that you could probably, touch on. And people that have free time, we went all over San Diego because we had free time to do that ourselves. And then each state actually has events.
Yes.
And they're all set in their own little areas, so it's huge. I mean, you figure every single state will have, you may have a Cavs thing. You may have, they have different themes, and they're all different. So I remember Ohio, at that time, Bob Taft was the governor, so the governor actually will place what kind of event that they would have. So that might be another place to touch with the governor and try to get something down this way. I just know how it worked because I had attended one.
No, that's a great point, and that's the other thing is who are your state representatives and things like that, and make sure you let them know that, hey, we're here, we're ready, willing, and able to host. That's a great, great point.
The number of rooms.
Yes, sir.
Some people bring staff with them, and
yes,
there's a whole bunch of unidentified people that aren't delegates.
Yep.
In our press.
There's a lot of people that will never enter the convention hall because they don't have credentials, but they want to be here, or they're part of an entourage, or they're here to go to parties and network and things like that.
Could that
spill out this way? Oh, absolutely. And don't forget, it's July and there's no rooms anywhere else. So there's just going to be natural compression to the next ring. And so, that's normally a heavy, the hotels are busy that time of year. You can't get a hotel room in downtown Cleveland normally that time of year. Well, where are those people going to go? Yes?
Is the Football Hall of Fame Village reconstruction, is that supposed to be done?
It won't be. No, unfortunately, it won't be. That's a really cool project, but it won't. I think maybe phase one will be done. Which might be the stadium. So, but it's a great asset to have and to market for sure. But I wish that's going to be really cool. I'm done. Okay. Thank you, everyone. I'll stick around too.
Thank you so much, Mike. And actually, what an excellent presentation. And if anyone here, a great way to begin or to start getting involved is right there across the bottom. And even if you wanted to tweet something or Instagram something about this morning's presentation and already start the ball rolling for being involved in that way and to use those hashtags also. So thank you all for being... Oh, Jackie, if you... Okay, and then in case you couldn't hear, it's hashtag 2016 Ashtabula County. And Jackie, if you wouldn't mind tweeting something with that right now, then maybe some people here in the room can follow, favorite, or retweet that also. That would be great. Well, thank you all for being here. Next month's presentation is on GIS, Geographic Information Systems. Who here knows what that means? A lot of people here. Which is fantastic. It's a lot about big data and how that impacts us. And if you aren't aware, the GIS systems that map out our, think of Google Maps and then think of it right here in this room, underneath us, below us, the manholes outside, knowing where all of our infrastructure is. And these GIS systems can save organizations and communities between 10 to 30% in knowing how to plan for the future, how to plan for their fleets, and to be prepared. So when it comes down to even things at your home and knowing where the roads are or knowing what's underneath, how your sewer system gets there, all about that. And give you an example of just how exciting and interesting GIS is. About several years back, a young man said to me, I believe it was on our second date, I have the neatest thing ever to show you. And it was GIS mapping system. Turns out I married him. So it was pretty interesting. So one of our speakers next week, next month, that'll be introducing the topic is Jim Hockaday, the city manager of Conneaut also. So again, thank you all for being here and enjoy the rest of your day.